everyone, Brent Jaswinski here, bringing you the latest step in the development of head protection by Alpinestars, the all-new Supertech R10 road racing helmet. Alpinestars' approach to the creation of the advanced technology in the Supertech R10 draws on our depth of experience from 60 years of world-class innovation across the spectrum of motorsports. The result of over 10 years of intensive study, development, and testing, the goal of the Supertech family of helmets was to create the most advanced, protective, and performance-enhancing helmets possible for racers and riders worldwide. And as always with Alpinestars products, protection is paramount and our primary objective when we kick off the design process. The secondary objective was to engineer the perfect blend of excellent ventilation, unsurpassed comfort, and create helmets with the lightest weight possible, all without compromising on any other front. Another critical component unique to the SR10's design and development was advanced aerodynamics by reducing drag and providing optimal aerodynamic stability. Homologated to ECE 2206, DOT, and FIM standards, the Supertech R10's shell construction utilizes a highly advanced molding technology with a multi-composite combination, featuring a 3K high-density carbon outer layer, a unidirectional carbon composite layer, and an aramid fiber layer. The 3K high-density carbon outer layer provides excellent strength and efficiency of energy dissipation over the shell. The unidirectional carbon composite layer provides significantly greater radial strength around the shell, preventing compression but allowing for controlled deflection for reducing transmitted impact energy. And then the aramid fiber plus fiberglass layer provides critical penetration protection. Everything is bonded together with an advanced epoxy resin already applied on the prepreg fiber, and it perfectly controls the ideal proportion of resin versus fiber to maximize strength, mechanical performance, and light weight. The result of the SR10's unique shell construction results in extremely effective impact protection. With a fully equipped in-house helmet testing facility within our state-of-the-art Alpinestars Research and Development Center, we've carried out an exhaustive impact research program. Our research and development efforts have resulted in the helmet returning linear and oblique impact performance, which far exceeds the current ECE 2206 helmet regulation standard limits. For direct linear impacts, which is an impact at a 90 degree angle between the helmet and an object, the SR10 surpasses the standard by an average magnitude of 37%. And for rotational acceleration and oblique impact performance, where impact energy comes from an angle other than a linear 90 degree or right angle straight impact, the SR10 exceeds the standard by 65%. The helmet shell itself comes available in 4 anatomical sizes, offering construction optimized to ensure riders have the correct fit, which not only improves comfort and reduces overall weight, but most importantly, improves the effectiveness of the helmet in an impact. Underneath the helmet's outer shell is also an 8-piece multi-density EPS liner, with 6 specific densities strategically positioned in different zones to ensure not only excellent energy absorption from impact forces dissipated over the outer shell, but also to ensure a close and comfortable fit. The EPS liner, just like the outer shell, has its own unique dimension for each helmet size, further tailoring the helmet's performance and fit when it comes to protection and comfort. When it comes to other types of helmet testing, we know that the best helmets are those that provide protection against both linear impact and rotational force. To help fight and mitigate those rotational impact forces, Alpinestars has designed a low friction surface on the inner surface of the EPS liner. The inner surface is polished to be incredibly smooth and then specially coated to reduce friction even further, allowing the comfort liner to move against the EPS. The result is increased rotational force management, allowing the rider's head to move independently inside of the helmet or vice versa, which can significantly reduce the amount of force transmitted to the head, neck, brain, and spine from an oblique impact, while simultaneously reducing the possibility of a concussion. So, as a recap, specific rotational impact protection is provided by the combination of the internal shape and specific coating of the EPS liner, coupled to the specially developed surface in the comfort liner. This patented technology reduces rotational acceleration transmitted to the rider's head. Speaking of the comfort liner, the SR10 has 8 individual internal parts, consisting of the crown pad, top pad, cheek pads, chin curtain, chin strap, ear pads, wind deflector, and breath deflector. The crown pad and neck pad are elastically connected for better oblique impact management and interface with the smooth surface of the inner EPS liner. The cheek pads are fitted with 3D foam along with the ERS emergency extraction system, plus a channel for hydration hose installation. A chin curtain is available inside the box to provide further protection against air entering from below. Ear pads are fixed and help to improve comfort by reducing the aerodynamic noise, plus are removable to install speakers for communication devices. And finally, wind and breath deflectors are included to improve aerodynamic behavior and humid airflow, respectively. Adding to the personalization and custom tailor-made fit of the SR10 is its unique and patented A-head fitment system. The A-head system allows the helmet to be tuned exactly to the rider's preference by having the ability to adjust both the height and angle at which the helmet sits on the head. With the micro-adjustable pad that is connected to the helmet inner EPS liner, the A-head design allows for an ultra-specific setup that can be adapted to how deep the rider's head sits in the helmet, as well as how far forward or back it's tilted. Additionally, and further tailoring the SR10's fit to better suit a wide variety of different head shapes and sizes, is the ability to change and swap out the cheek pads, crown pad, and top pad with a selection of both thinner and thicker options to truly customize comfort for a perfect fit. So between the various inner comfort liner options, plus the unique and patented A-head system, there's virtually countless inner fitment configurations to suit the fit and performance needs of all riders. When it comes to aerodynamics, the SR10 has been developed in the full-scale wind tunnel since the beginning of its development. Aerodynamic targets for coefficient of drag in different head positions, as well as stability at different angles, were a primary goal in the helmet shape development. First extensively developed with computational fluid dynamics, then validated in the full-scale wind tunnel, and finally on track. The result is the helmet that achieves the lowest level of drag and the highest level of aerodynamic stability at high speed compared to any other race helmet we have tested in the wind gallery. This has made the SR10 already the helmet of choice by factory MotoGP teams for its top aero performance. The road rider will benefit from this too, with reduced strain on their neck at high speeds and low levels of wind noise. The SR10 comes with 2 separate aerodynamic spoilers, a standard and a longer race version, and they're both fitted with our patented release system, with elastic joints that help the spoiler detach from the helmet shell if it's subjected to a significant impact, no matter the angle, to reduce potential rotational energy. Another big benefit of this extensive aero development for the rider is the adoption of lateral winglets and a race spoiler, which provides an additional drag reduction of 4.54% versus the helmet in road configuration, and significantly increases the helmet's stability. This makes a relevant difference at all speeds, but is even more pronounced and measurable the faster you go. Speaking of going fast, let's hear it from current Red Bull KTM factory MotoGP rider, Jack Miller.
Hey everybody, I'm Jack Miller, and I've been racing with the SR10 throughout the 2023 season. One of the key features that I've enjoyed throughout my time wearing the helmet is definitely the aerodynamic stability of the helmet, the way it cuts through the air. One of the biggest fatigue areas for us is definitely your neck muscles and the way that the helmet can pull up or pull down. And fortunately enough for us with this helmet, they've done a lot of work in that area and it's not an issue. There's nothing worse than having your helmet shaking or moving around whilst trying to focus on whether it be passing the guy in front of you or hitting your marks on the racetrack. So having that stability, not having to worry about, you know, keeping my head stable, just knowing that once I put it on the tank, she's gonna be there and be solid. For a brand new helmet, we covered everything with flying colors and can't wait for you all to try it at home.
Another outer shell design protection feature is the chin bar's profile, where the base area has been specifically sculpted to give a relief section. The bottom profile is not only raised to clear the collarbone, but also, instead of the hard carbon shell coming into potential contact with the collarbone, it's actually the softer EPP expanded polypropylene liner, which extends beyond the helmet shell itself, and is covered by a more flexible rubber compound. This design provides a reduced chance of any sort of collarbone injury, one of the more common injuries in motorcycling. When it comes to the shield and eye port, the SR10 is fitted with an ECE 2206 homologated optical class 1 shield with anti-scratch and anti-fog treatment. The shield varies in thickness from 1.6 millimeters on the sides to 2.6 millimeters in the center, and is provided with pins to attach a pinlock 120 XLT 100% max vision lens included in the SR10's purchase, plus pins provided for tear-offs with 3 included. The visor itself will come clear as standard, but will have the option of a medium smoke, dark smoke, mirrored silver, and photochromic lens options. The visor itself also has 2 unique features, including a metal locking mechanism lever to prevent unwanted shield detachment during impacts and/or crashes, plus a lowered sideline for maximized field of view, coming on top of an already outstanding wide eye port, providing 220 degrees of lateral and 57 degrees of vertical visibility for great riding comfort. Additionally, the visor itself can be easily changed or removed thanks to its secure and toolless quick release system. When it comes to ventilation and breathability, there are 11 ventilation ports, not including the eye port, with 7 intakes, including 3 in the chin guard and 4 on the top of the helmet, plus 4 exhausts, with 2 lateral ports on the chin bar and 2 on the top rear of the helmet. These ventilation ports integrate directly with the helmet shell with a series of air ducts through the inner EPS liner. So airflow isn't just coming in through the ports, it's actively circulating over and around the rider's head through a series of channels and getting pulled out the back. But let's hear it from Prima Pramac Ducati's Jorge Martin's experience, who just came off one of the hottest and most exciting performances in MotoGP history.
Hey everybody, I'm Jorge Martin, and yeah, as you know, 2023 was a really challenging year, not also for me, but also for, you know, the new Alpinestars SR10. In terms of visibility, it was always amazing. You have a really clear vision of everything that is going on. Also, the heat conditions was an amazing helmet. We had these ventilations that are helping a lot to get there into the head and to refresh a little bit. And a really important thing is aerodynamics. You can see a really aggressive helmet. We tried on the wind tunnel, and we watched a bit better than other helmets. So that's a reason also that why we started working together. I've been super happy with the helmet for all the season. It can work perfectly, not only for racing, but also for the street. It's a really complete helmet. If you are on the street with this one, you're really one of the most liked ones.
The top vent features a large central slider, which channels air down to the top of the head for better comfort, which also, when open, has vents for hot air extraction from the rider's forehead. Under the rear spoiler, there are 2 extractor vents for effective hot air exhausting. The chin vents are formed by 2 openings located at the front of the helmet at the sides of the shield lock mechanism, with each flap having a tab in the corner, which is used to open or close the vent. Air entering from this point will be channeled towards the inner side of the shield, creating a laminated flow of air that effectively prevents fogging and misting. And additionally, the chin bar vents are used to extract humid air to the outside of the helmet. And finally, when it comes to weight, the ECE DOT and FIM certified Supertech R10 helmet tips the scales at an impressive 1,550 grams for a size medium, or 3.4 pounds. Providing the SR10 with an extremely high performance to protection to weight ratio. In terms of added value, the SR10 comes with several added bonuses. In addition to the spare visor, the 2 separate race and standard spoilers, the chin curtain plus wind and breath deflectors, provided in the purchase of the graphic colorway Alpinestars Supertech R10 helmet, will also be a dedicated paddock helmet bag to keep the helmet and all its spare parts safe and secure and all in one place. The solid colorways will not include the race spoiler or helmet bag, but the full set of accessories otherwise. However, all spare parts are fully available if needed. Available for spring 24, the Alpinestars Supertech R10 helmet will come in 6 sizes, extra small through 2XL, and in both solid and graphic colorways. Solid colors will include black carbon matte and glossy, plus white glossy and matte black. And for graphic colorways, we'll have two graphics with two colorways each. First up, the team graphic, available in black carbon, red, white glossy, and black carbon, red fluo, dark blue, matte. And finally, we have the element graphic, available in black carbon, bright red, white glossy, and black carbon, silver, black glossy. As you know, the Supertech R10 helmet has made its debut in MotoGP in the 2023 season with Jack Miller, Jorge Martin, and Jonas Folger. For the 2024 season, we're adding another rider to the roster wearing the SR10 in the MotoGP class. Together, let's see who he is.
Hi everyone, I'm Pedro Acosta and welcome to the Alpinestars Supertech R10 live stream. Like you can see, I'm in the Alpinestars test lab and I was gearing Alpinestars since the days of Rookies Cup, Moto3 and Moto2, and also waiting for gear the Alpinestars Supertech R10 helmet in a MotoGP bike. My first impression about the Alpinestars Supertech R10 helmet was quite good, also quite comfortable, but also was quite ventilated. This is always nice when we go to hot countries. The vision area was quite hard compared to the helmet that I was using in the past, also quite easy to use the locket in the visor and all around the vision for this was quite good impression at the beginning. I have the opportunity to try the A-head adjustment system for the people that is not professional and don't have the facilities that we have on a race weekend. It was quite easy to adapt to my head. I know that it's not normally easy like that because everyone had his own head, you know, and it was quite easy to use it.
We're at the end of our event here, but before closing, the full line of Supertech R10 helmets is going to be available in the US and in Europe in March, with limited online availability and in select North American retailers starting today. The SR10 will also come to Asia with a dedicated Asian fit in the second part of 2024. This is your opportunity to be among the first to own an SR10 where you can shop it after the end of this live stream on the Alpinestars website. Thank you so much for your attention. We look forward to seeing the Supertech R10 become a reality, not just in MotoGP, but on roads and racetracks around the world. Alpinestars, one goal, one vision.